Welcome to the Ironman 70.3 Auckland Athlete Race Briefing. Further to this race briefing, athletes are required to read the Athlete Information Guide, which contains additional information to ensure you have a great day. This is available online at ironmanauckland.com. If you have any questions at the end of this presentation, please see the Event Information Centre or the Check-in Help Desk. There are some essential items that you need to take part in the race. Please ensure you receive the following items in your race pack: coloured swim cap, race number tattoo, category tattoo, race number, helmet and bike sticker, athlete wristband. If you are missing any of these items, please head along to the help desk at check-in or see the team at the information centre outside the Viaduct Event Centre. Bike racking is on Saturday from 10 a.m. till 4 p.m. Please bring your helmet and be ready for a Try NZ official to ensure it meets safety standards. You must leave your helmet with your bike overnight. The bike racks are individually numbered. Please ensure that you rack your bike at your assigned position. Shimano bike mechanics will be available to assist with any last minute adjustments. Please note the service is for minor repairs only. On race morning, transition opens at 4:45 a.m. and closes at 6:15 a.m. All athletes must be clear of transition at this time. No bags or boxes are to be left in transition. Remove all excess equipment and make use of the bag drop inside the Viaduct Event Centre. Any bags or boxes left in transition will be removed. Individuals have been issued with race number tattoos. You are required to self-apply these prior to the race start. Instructions on application and removal are included in your race pack. The race number should be applied to the individual's right arm and category on your right calf. Team members have been issued with a category tattoo for the team runner only. Please ensure you have planned ahead for your race day travel and advise your friends and family of the road restrictions in place. We strongly advise you utilise the downtown and Fanshawe parking buildings. For more information on road closures and parking restrictions, please see our website. Swim course is 1.9 kilometres, one lap. Swim anti-clockwise, keeping swim buoys 1, 2 and 3 on your left and swim buoys 4, 5 and 6 on your right. Ironman 70.3 Auckland Athlete Race Briefing. Further to this race briefing, athletes are required to read the Athlete Information Guide, which contains additional information to ensure you have a great day. This is available online at ironmanauckland.com. If you have any questions at the end of this presentation, please see the Event Information Centre or the Check-in Help Desk. Once you have made your final preparations in transition, you'll make your way to the swim start. This is a short walk across the Te Whero footbridge to the New Zealand Maritime Museum. You'll be directed into your wave starts as per your swim cap colours and led onto the swim start pontoon in that order. The swim is a deep water start. Please ensure you listen to all instructions to prepare you for your start. You must start in your assigned wave start. If you miss your wave, you will start with the last wave, but your start time will be recorded at your official start. Please ensure you are familiar with your start time. Once a preceding wave has started, you will be allowed to enter the water. The next wave will be given access onto the pontoon at this time. There will be limited time before each wave for a water warm-up, so please ensure you keep moving while outside. You will enter the water in single file onto a pontoon. You must cross the timing mat at this point. This is for health and safety reasons. Your race time starts when your wave starts. Please be patient during the start process and do not attempt to access the pontoon before you are instructed. If at any time you want to withdraw, you must report to a race official. Athletes are advised to be ready at their assigned colour point no later than 6:15 a.m. as advertised race start times can change. Swim safety is provided by Surf Life Saving New Zealand. If you at any time need assistance, raise one arm above your head. Please look after those around you and raise your arm if you see another athlete in distress. Take extra care on the swim exit as the steps are uneven and will be slippery. The time limit for the swim leg is 1 hour. The swim course cutoff time is 8:30 a.m. Due to the wave start, some athletes have longer in the water. Any athlete who registers a time exceeding 1 hour and finishes before 8:30 a.m. will be allowed to continue, however will be removed from the official results and will not be eligible for age group awards or world championship slots. Any athlete who has not completed the course by 8:30 a.m. will not be able to continue. Bike course is 90 kilometres. One lap of the Northern Loop via the Auckland Harbour Bridge and two laps of the City Loop. The turnaround is on Tāmaki Drive prior to Long Drive. This course includes a number of technical and challenging elements and we advise that extreme caution be taken at all times. New Zealand road rules apply. You must keep left at all times unless directed otherwise by an event official. Treat all roads as open to other users at all times. There are some areas of the bike course which are very narrow and will have athletes travelling in both directions. These areas include, but not limited to, Curran Street, Shelley Beach and Onewa Road off-ramps. All of these areas are single file only. You will be asked to slow down and take extreme care at these areas. Please obey all instructions from all race officials. Due to the nature of this course, there are additional hazards to be aware of. Uneven surfaces, including the exit and entrance to transition. Speed humps on West Haven and Tamaki Drive. Please slow down and get off your aero bars. Finger joints on the Auckland Harbour Bridge. These will be covered by event officials, but you are instructed to slow down, get off your aero bars, and take extreme care. Tram tracks are located on Halsey, Hammer, and Jellicoe Streets. These will be covered on race day, but you are instructed to slow down, get off your aero bars, and take extreme care. Additional care will be required if wet. We repeat and advise extreme care and caution at all times and on all parts of the course. Pay special attention to Curran Street, Shelley Beach on and off ramp, and Onewa Road on ramp. These are extremely narrow and caution is required. Given the distances that this course covers, there is a large part of the course that is not cordoned off. Please take extra care at these areas and be aware of spectator and pedestrian movement and crossing the course at all times. Shimano bike mechanics and recovery vehicles will be roaming on course. However, they can only assist you with equipment. They are unable to assist you with repairs. There are intermediate cutoffs in place that will be imposed. 9:35 a.m. athletes must have reached Constellation Drive bus station inbound. 9:45 a.m. athletes must have reached weigh station before Auckland Harbour Bridge climb inbound. 11:05 a.m. athletes must have reached the start of the second lap at Madden and Doherty Street. 11:30 a.m. athletes must have reached the second bike turn at St Heliers. Any athletes who have not passed these points by this time will be withdrawn from the race and will be assisted back to transition by official vehicles. Run course is 21.1 kilometres, 2 laps. Due to the uniqueness of this course, there are a number of places where the course is narrow and will have two-way runners. Please keep to the left and be aware of those around you at all times. Take extra care on the paved pathways, particularly if it is wet. The run course is 2 laps around the Viaduct Harbour out to the turnaround on Tamaki Drive. You'll be issued with an armband at 500 metres into the start of each lap. The run course finish cut-off time is 3 p.m. There are intermediate cut-off times in place that will be imposed. 1:30 p.m. athletes must have started the second lap at Karanga Plaza. 2:15 p.m. athletes must have reached the run turn on Tamaki Drive for the second time. Any athletes who have not passed these points at these times will be withdrawn from the race and will be assisted back to transition by an official vehicle. There is one aid station on the bike course. You have access to this three times. The bottle drop and pickup is on Hammer Street. The drop zone is 200 metres before the pickup. Hawley's Replace and water will be available. There are three aid stations on the run course. You will have access to these nine times. There will be Hawley's Replace, Hawley's Gels, water, cola and bananas available. The drop zone is 100 metres before and after the aid stations only. Once you have crossed the finish line, all individual finishers will receive a medal and a finisher's towel. There is a recovery area available before you meet friends and family. The recovery area is for athletes only. Please do not invite your supporters into this area. Bag collection will also be available. St John will be available at this point if required. Team changeover is to take place in transition where the team bike is racked. The baton is the transponder. The swimmer must start with it and the runner must finish with it. The team biker must wait for the swimmer at their bike and the swimmer will come to them. The runner must wait for the biker where the bike was racked and the biker will come to them. This event is sanctioned by Triathlon New Zealand. The Tri-NZ race referee is Tony Sangster, and the event race director is Wayne Reardon. The competition jury is a technical delegate, the race director and a representative of Triathlon New Zealand. Triathlon is an individual sport. No outside assistance is allowed at any time. The event is conducted under Tri-NZ race rules, with some Ironman addendums. These are available to view online. Athletes are expected to be familiar with these. Cut-off times will be enforced. Doping regulations apply and any athlete could be selected for drug testing. If you are randomly selected for drug testing, you will require photo ID. No headsets, camera or recording device of any kind are to be worn at any point during the race. This includes iPods and GoPros. Tri-NZ technical officials will be on course monitoring and enforcing the rules. Here are some of the key rules for this event. Swim course. You must wear the event swim cap on the outside of all other caps. It's a deep water start. Wave starts. Ensure you have checked your start time. Stay behind the start line. It's 300 metres to the first turn. You must complete the full course. No webbed gloves or booties. Wetsuits are allowed. and the water temperature is approximately 20 degrees. Transition. Positions will be numbered. Please do not leave any bags or boxes in transition, as these will be removed prior to race start. Teams will tag at their bike position. Please mount your bike after the mount line and dismount before the dismount line. Penalties will be enforced for infringements. Bike course. Treat all roads as open. Please keep to the left. Ensure you have your helmet and bike sticker attached. Race number is not compulsory on the bike. Do not cross the centre line. Do not overtake on the left. Discards at the bike aid station only. No blocking. This event is non-drafting. The draft zone is 10 metres by 3 metres. These are all subject to penalties or disqualification. This diagram shows the drafting zone. You have 20 seconds to pass through this zone. This diagram shows the vehicle drafting zone. Run course. Keep to the left-hand side of the course. Race number is compulsory and must be worn to the front. Discards at aid stations only. Penalty boxes. Two penalty boxes are in operation on the bike course. One near the bike aid station and one on the outward leg at Mission Bay, Tāmaki Drive. During the bike, an official will attract your attention by a whistle, then will indicate the number of the athlete penalised by showing a number on a yellow slip of paper. If penalised, please stop at the next penalty box. Failure to do so will result in disqualification. This event has a 3-minute stop-go penalty where applicable. Ironman would like to thank the officials from Triathlon New Zealand who have volunteered their time to be involved. This event offers 50 qualifying slots to the Ironman 70.3 World Championship in Austria. Slot allocation and roll-down will immediately follow the awards ceremony, which starts at 4 p.m. You must be present to accept your slot. Please join us right back here at the Viaduct Event Centre for the awards ceremony at 4 p.m. Sunday afternoon. The top three in each category are acknowledged. This event requires over 600 volunteers to make it a success. The Ports of Auckland are proud sponsors of our volunteers. Please take your time to thank them as you enjoy your day. Special thanks to our host city Auckland and our gold sponsors Ports of Auckland and our team sponsors Claymore Partners. Thanks also to Hawley's Nutrition, Active.com, ASICS, Shimano, Crown Plaza Hotel, Timex, MediaWorks, Australian Triathlete Magazine, NZ Triathlon Magazine and Triathlon New Zealand. Also thanks to NZTA, Auckland Transport, Waterfront Auckland, Viaduct Harbour and the New Zealand Maritime Museum and to the local businesses and residents for supporting this event. Make-A-Wish challenges you to become a wish racer. Make-A-Wish is a fantastic organisation granting awesome wishes to Kiwi kids with life-threatening medical conditions, which is why they are our official charity for Ironman 70.3 Auckland. You can still help and make a difference. To find out more about Make-A-Wish in New Zealand, head along to their expo stand. This event takes place in New Zealand's biggest city. This is your chance to showcase the sport of Ironman and your talents to the people of Auckland. Please remain aware that there will be those on and around the course who may be unfamiliar with the sport and remain sportsmanlike in your behaviour at all times. If you have any questions, see the team at the Event Information Centre. Full course maps and a copy of the Athlete Information Guide are also available to view here. We look forward to seeing you again in December at Ironman 70.3 Taupo.